The latest release of Darktable has several really good changes. Here are some of the most interesting ones in my opinion. The new module called Sigmoid does a very sensible scene to display tone mapping. There is nothing it does that you can't do with Filmic, but if you feel like Filmic is way overhead, you might want trying Sigmoid. Good results, less controls to deal with. However, while the general idea of making good results easier achievable is great, you are essentially getting another way of doing the same, which has become a bit of a user experience issue in Darktable. The Highlights Reconstruction module now has two new methods of restoring highlights, in-paint a post and segmentation based. Let's take this extreme example. So this is no reconstruction, this is clip highlights, this is reconstructing LCH. Now this is in-paint a post, and this is the segmentation-based method. In-paint a post is slower than just clipping highlights, but it's reliable, it works very well, and it is now the default method. The lens correction module can now read and use embedded lens metadata in EXIF to apply a correction. Not all camera manufacturers support this metadata, but in my case of Fujifilm, the metadata is written and allows both correcting geometry distortions and fixing the vignetting. The snapshot module got a long overdue internal revamp. This is no longer a fixed screenshot of your edit, so you can actually zoom in and pan around. In the Lighttable view, it is now possible to preview a user-generated or imported style of processing. You need to select a photo, then just place the mouse pointer over a style on the list, and this tooltip will appear. Unfortunately, this feature is rather sluggish. It takes time to build the preview, at least on my laptop, and then as you can see, it doesn't handle long style names very well. There are many other changes. WebP and JPEG Excel support, better caching in the pixel processing pipeline, better slideshow user experience, and more. You can find all that in the release notes, the link is in the description below. Unfortunately, some of the usability issues have not been addressed yet, such as the duplicated filter functionality in the sidebar and in the top bar of the Lighttable view. Other than that, it is a very much welcome update.